Cloud Manager Image 16 offers more flexibility in cloning environments. For databases in the Exadata database system on a dedicated infrastructure service, you're no longer limited to cloning a container database, or CDB, with a single pluggable database, or PDB. This image provides multi-tenant capabilities to Exadata systems with enhanced cloning. You can choose from three cloning types. Remote cloning copies the source PDB to a different existing CDB. To configure a remote clone, select the existing container database. You must also supply the TDE wallet password for the CDB. The new CDB clone type creates a new container database in the same Exadata cluster and copies the PDB to the new CDB. Supply a name for the new CDB that is unique in the Exadata cluster. Local cloning copies the source PDB to a target PDB in the same container database in the Exadata cluster. No additional configuration is needed for the local clone type. Additionally, the configuration for compute nodes for cloned environments now allows you to select a VCN and subnet that are different from that of the source environment. You can change the network configuration for compute nodes for full tier, mid-tier, and search nodes. After saving the configuration for the database node and compute nodes, click Clone. When the environment provisioning is complete, you can view the cloned PDB on the Exadata page in OCI. This completes our demonstration of the Enabling Exadata Multi-Tenancy with Enhanced Cloning feature. Cloud Manager Image 16 provides new features to help you manage passwords. You can now centrally store and manage passwords in OCI Vault, which is a secure password storage mechanism. Use the new Password Groups page to avoid manually entering or remembering the passwords during creation of environments or templates. You can now reset the passwords of a provisioned environment in Cloud Manager by selecting the Use Password Group field on the Manage Passwords page. This automatically updates the passwords to the target environment. To update just the Cloud Manager metadata when the password changes are already updated in the target environment, click the Update Metadata button. When creating an environment, the OCI Vault API integration with Cloud Manager enables you to manage environment passwords directly from Cloud Manager. The credentials from the selected password group are fetched from OCI and can't be edited. Additionally, Cloud Manager allows you to use password groups to set up templates for provisioned environments. This completes the Simplified Password Management Using OCI Vault feature description. You can now take advantage of Cloud Manager's governance framework to set up a policy that automatically uses PUM images that are downloaded to the repository to provision a new environment. Before setting up the policy to provision environments, set up a vault to hold your passwords in OCI, as mentioned in the previous segment of this video. After creating the vault, you add an encryption key and enter the passwords as vault secrets. Vaults use secrets to store credentials such as passwords, SSH keys, or authentication tokens. When specifying your passwords in Cloud Manager, you select the OCID rather than typing in the password. In Cloud Manager, go to My Settings and create a new password group. To set up the password group, associate the passwords needed for environment provisioning, such as Database Connect ID password, with the correct vault secrets. The vault secrets are identified on the Password Groups page by OCID and will be used for provisioning environments as directed by the policy. Go to the repository and ensure that there is a download subscription for the image you want to provision, such as HCM. On the My Downloads page, verify that the image is available in the repository. Add a template. The template is defined for an image present in the repository. When you use the template with an auto-provisioning policy, the policy will substitute the latest downloaded image. Select a PUM full-tier topology. Under Custom Attributes, choose the password group. Save the template after completing the setup. Now define a new policy with Policy Object Repository Artifact, Type Event, and Event Name PUM DPK Download. Select the image and release for your update image. The policy action is PUM Provision. The policy action requires two parameters. Enter a prefix, which will be appended to the environment name. Then select the PUM Full Tier template. The list includes only those templates that have associated password groups. When a new HCM image is available in the repository, the policy creates the environment. The environment name is comprised of the prefix entered as a policy parameter, plus the image release and update image number. The description indicates that the environment was auto-provisioned through a policy. This completes our demonstration of the Automatic Provisioning of PUM Images feature. Prior to Image 16, the auto-scaling visualization on the monitoring page in Cloud Manager only provided a view of the monitoring data with the current and recommended number of mid-tier nodes. You could only view anomaly detection data for a given time interval with respect to the HTTP request metric. With this image, Cloud Manager displays the system usage in a separate section on the monitoring page and enables you to view the anomaly data for 12 additional metrics, such as app server system CPU load. Use your mouse scroll button to zoom in and out on the system usage chart. Select HTTP requests with hourly intervals. To drill down into hourly or bi-hourly data points, click the Data Point Interval link below the graph. In this view, the non-anomalous nodes, anomalous remove nodes, and anomalous add nodes are represented in green, blue, and red, respectively. Cloud Manager displays a line chart by default. You can also view the data in the form of a bar chart by selecting that option on the top left corner of the page. When you hover above the bars on a bar chart for a particular metric, the chart displays values of the other metrics. To go back to the original view, click the Drill Up button. Select Weekly as the interval for HTTP requests. The System Usage chart displays the current and recommended values for mid-tier nodes, as well as forecasted values over a selected data point interval. Forecasted data is available only on daily and weekly charts for the HTTP requests metric. This completes our demonstration of the additional monitoring metrics enhancement. Cloud Manager Image 16 uses the Disaster Recovery Service in OCI, enabling you to replicate primary region resources like middle tier and DBS to a standby region, ensuring business continuity. This is an automated process. Select Enable Disaster Recovery and the Standby Region on the Infrastructure Settings page to enable the service for an environment. Ensure that the VCN of the source environment is paired with the VCN of the selected standby region and click Submit. The Disaster Recovery Service is enabled only for environments with a database system or DBS. You can create only one standby environment per source environment. A standby environment can't have a disaster recovery option. On the Create Standby Environment page, provide a name for the standby environment and select the region for the environment. Use the Configure button to edit general settings like host name and shape name, as well as network configuration details associated with the standby environment. The compartment name and host name are pre-filled on the Disaster Recovery Database page. You can select the rest of the values according to the specifications required for the standby environment. After you save the database node configuration, click Configure to specify the shape, host name, subnet, and network information for each compute node. Save the environment configuration and click Submit to create the standby environment. You can use the Oracle Full Stack Disaster Recovery, or FSDR, to create and automate disaster recovery plans based on the standby environment created through Cloud Manager. After the standby environment is created, you can use Oracle FSDR to create a disaster recovery protection group and plan to complete the disaster recovery setup. This completes the OCI Disaster Recovery Service Support feature description. We've only shown you the highlights of this Cloud Manager update. For more information and other enhancements, see the CFO tool, the image overview on My Oracle Support, and go to the PeopleSoft Information Portal for updates.